Oh yeah, my mom's, she's done CrossFit for a long time, like a really long time. I don't remember when we had a normal, unhealthy meal. I see her singing. That's the most thing she did, dance and sing. But yeah, I've been listening to all her videos that we have of her singing, and it's my new favorite sound. She made our family whole. She was our glue. So that's gonna be a big part of us that's missing.
I see her smile on my daughter a lot, you know. I look at her, she smiles, and I see Eva. It's the same smile.
Whether it was running, crossfitting, or going to the local state parks here, you know, just her love of being active, her love of fitness is something that we'll always remember about her.
With Eva, just the smile that you couldn't look away from, just giving of herself, very selfless. I love that about her. She just simply loved her family and loved Uvalde and loved her friends.
I believe she was a great teacher because of just her attitude. She was always, you know, in a great mood, smiling, talking.
She did everything to make sure everybody was okay. You know, she was the last person to think about herself. She was always worried about me, worried about my daughter, worried about her kids. You know, she didn't worry about herself. She worried about everybody else.
I'll remember Eva by her infectious smile, her headband to when that meant get the job done. She would give maximum effort for an hour. It's fitting that we were Eva Strong because to me, she was strong. Like, she was really strong.
During the pandemic, we there was a lot of gyms that were closed. So we needed an avenue out to continue working out. So we would meet at the Honey Bowl, and she would get there with her bag ready to roll. Her husband would carry all the utilities, the wall balls and the weights, jump ropes. And she would get the music ready, and we'll walk into Honey Bowl, and this is what we're gonna do it, guys, right here. Suck it up.
In the process of establishing a hero wad in her name and in her honor, she really embodies that to me, a hero. She was taken from us protecting her students. And that's one of the greatest legacies I think she's gonna leave behind. She touched the lives of so many people.
So we came here today. We definitely wanted to do a team WOD. Eva loved team competitions, did them very regularly with her partner, Katie. I also knew I needed to accommodate a lot of athletes without a lot of equipment, because I knew at this gym, people are just gonna come. I mean, you just give the word and they're gonna show up. Eva Strong is 5 rounds per time, 24 double unders, followed by 19 toast bar and 2 clean and jerks with a 400 meter run. It's designed to be done as a team because Eva loved team workouts. She was awesome at double unders and toast bar and loved a heavy barbell. And of course, running. She was always running.
When you think about all of the CrossFit hero wads and the stories behind those, this is another story of a real hero, a true hero. And Eva is that for us. She's that for those children.
Community is absolutely instrumental with this whole situation. I definitely am grateful to have these people and have this love for each other first and foremost. We're people first, fitness second. And that's how it's always been for us, and that's how it always will be, so.